whole world is fighting to overcome coronavirus. India too is doing its best. Now what do the people who are concerned about this coronavirus and its spread have to say? With us we have Rajiv Bajaj, the MD of Bajaj Auto. Let's talk to him. Yeah, Rajiv, what would you like to say? You have some kind of suggestions that homeopath can be a solution. What is that and why do you say so?
Well, Pankaj, my contention is that fundamentally there are only two things which can stop this virus. A, we have to all die, which is not the preferred solution. And the second is that we have to develop a herd immunity to the virus. How can we develop herd immunity? To the best of my understanding, and I am not an epidemiologist, but I know a little bit, particularly about homeopathy. Herd immunity can be developed by two ways broadly. Either by medicinal disease, in other words, you give a medicine to the patient which itself will cause the disease. In allopathy, this is called vaccination. But in homeopathy also, there is a solution for this. Why the homeopathic solution is not being pursued as of now, I really don't understand, but I can tell you more about it if you wish to know. As far as vaccination is concerned, we know that the best estimate is that for next 1 year, there is no vaccination. So in other words, getting immunity from medicinal approach is not possible because vaccine is not available and homeopathy is not permitted. Then the last option left is that we must get the immunity in a natural way. The population must get progressively infected and develop resistance, which is called nothing but developing a natural immunity. But this is not possible if we are going to lock down, theoretically, everybody completely. Because then we are suggesting that there will be no exposure to the virus. And if there is absolutely no exposure to the virus, by definition, there cannot be a development of herd immunity. However, this is only theoretical. And ultimately, we know that any virus or a flu virus is going to find its way around. There is no country in the world that has ever been able to arrest any flu virus in this fashion, which is why you are probably aware that even after decades of fighting the common flu, 600,000 people still die every year of that virus. So when that has not been arrested after all this time, how can this be arrested? And therefore, I do not see how this lockdown is a solution.
And your suggestion that homeopathy is one of the remedy to increase the immunity. So have you tried such a thing?
See, I can give you a little background. Homeopathy has been documented to have been quite effective in similar epidemics or pandemics. We can go as far back as the Spanish flu of 1918. We can look more recently at what happened in the Cuban epidemic. In both these cases, the doctors or the homeopaths who were treating with homeoprophylaxis, as it is called, which means using homeopathic remedy as a prophylactic, as a genus epidemicus, they lost a fraction of the patients that the allopaths lost using allopathy. I have also seen in, for example, swine flu time about 10 years back, that when we have given the homeopathic remedy gelsemium to about 50,000 people in our family, friends, colleagues, etc., to the best of my knowledge, not one person contracted swine flu, even though we are all living in Pune, which was the center of swine flu not only in Maharashtra but all of India, is what I understand. Pune had the maximum number of cases. Even currently, as you know well, we have a ministry called Ayush, which among other therapies is promoting homeopathy. So homeopathy is not a poison or a toxin. It is after all a medicine. And you will agree with me that even the strongest critics of homeopathy agree to one thing, that homeopathic medicines do not have any downside or any side effects which are negative. At the most, they say ki isme kuch nahi hai, ye placebo hai, this is a placebo, it will not have any benefit. But nobody says it will cause harm. So I am fortunate that our homeopath, Dr. Rajan Sankaran, who is based in Mumbai, he could get access to patients across many countries of the world, starting with Iran, Nepal, Romania, Bolivia, I think, Italy, France, Netherlands. And he has been able to treat successfully many patients in the last 6 weeks. Now, when I say treat successfully, what I mean is not that they recovered. We know most people will recover anyway. But the rate at which they recovered, the remarkable way they have recovered, gives us hope. And I will not say it's a solution, a guaranteed solution, but I will say it gives strong hope that camphor 1M, which is the remedy that he used, both as preventive and curative, can be effective in India as well. So what we have done on our part, because as Bajaj Auto, we have set up our own homeopathy center here about 10 years back in Pune called Prana. Through Prana, we have distributed as of today about 67,000 vials of camphor 1M. And each vial is good enough or has enough pills for 5 people. So that means that about 300,000 people have progressively received this homeopathic remedy. Of course, we cannot keep in touch with 300,000 people. But to best of our knowledge as of today, nobody has come back to us saying that after taking this remedy, I have now developed symptoms. So we are feeling a little hopeful that this is effective. We have all taken it. I have taken it. We have given it to our family, friends, colleagues, etc. And we have received the requests from everywhere. You will not believe how many ministers, how many business peers, even requests from the commissioner of police himself in Pune, or rather I should clarify, when I suggested it to him, he readily accepted this. If I'm not wrong, to the Pune police, we sent 9,000 vials for 45,000 people, the rural police, the PCMC police, the railway police. So effectively what is happening is that over 300,000 people in Pune have gratefully taken camphor 1M in the hope that it will protect them. But it is ironical that at the same time, despite approval of Ayush Ministry, which I have received personally, despite approval from Delhi, from the Central Council of Research for Homeopathy called CCRH, and despite approval from Maharashtra Council of Homeopathy called MCH, we are not getting the one last approval required from the agency called ICMR or from Health Ministry, let's put it like that, so that when we have given this remedy to 300,000 people, and let's say worst case scenario, it has no benefit, but it has no downside. Why are we not getting approval to give it to at least 30, 40, 50 infected people whom we cannot access because they are in government hospital, as you know, they are quarantined. So without the permission of ICMR, we cannot access these patients. We cannot conduct what is called a double blind random trial, where half the people are given the homeopathy, half are given nothing, they are given placebo. And if the first half recovers remarkably better than the second, then we have a scientific basis to say this works and let's go ahead with it. You will be surprised to know yesterday I received news from Dr. Rajan Sankaran that another similar interview I had done on this subject, and my interest is only to create awareness, otherwise my job is to make motorcycles. This interview I had done with Barkhadat has found its way across the world, for example, to the president of Botswana, who is now interested in making this available to all 2.3 million citizens of Botswana. Similarly, I have heard today that the Austrian Chancellor, Mr. Kurz, may be looking at homeopathy as a possible solution to be included. Nobody is saying you exclude allopathy or exclude hygiene or sanitation or masks or anything. We are not saying that at all. But why not also include something else which has a very good chance of success? And that is what the Austrian Chancellor is going to do. So what I see is that on the one hand, you have countries in Europe who, despite having smaller population, good medical infrastructure and reasonably better social security, they are looking at these solutions. But in our country, where our population is so large, medical infrastructure is relatively poor across the country, and social security is next to nothing, we are not willing to look at putting a few pills in a person's mouth. We would rather lock down for weeks on end, eventually letting many people lose jobs, lose salaries, and probably starve to death. This balance of such an extreme lockdown, I am not able to understand.
Lockdown for such a long time or extending the lockdown, you are against it?
I am against extending the lockdown, which is such an extreme lockdown. See, there is a lockdown all over the world. And I personally first want to suggest we should not be looking at Europe, UK, US. Because whether it is in terms of our inherent immunity, whether it is temperature, whether it is the demography of our young population, and even in terms of these factors we talked about like healthcare or social security, we are much more like Thailand, Malaysia, Indonesia, Philippines, Cambodia, etc. We are an Asian country. We are not a European country. Now let us look at the incidence of this problem. Whether infection or death in ASEAN country. Is it like it is in Italy, Spain, UK? It is not. So first of all, to benchmark Europe and go even ahead of Europe in terms of lockdown, I just don't understand. I am told by friends who live in New York that they can step out of their apartment. They are not having to necessarily wear masks. They can go to the grocery store. They can visit the friend in another apartment. Here, if my friends get down from the apartment, the police is coming after them with canes. I don't see the logic at all for this kind of lockdown. So I am all for advising the vulnerable people, which means the elderly people or those who have any other immunocompromised comorbidities, that you please still stay at home. I am all for ensuring hygiene, sanitation, personal protection, etc. I am all for saying that in any public space, if it is school, if it is office, if it is theater, it is mall, please take precautions, keep a distance. We don't want people at a very close proximity to each other. We have to go at 50% capacity. Whoever can work from home, work from home. That is all absolutely fine. But beyond that, I feel average age of India is only 28 years. Most of these people, 98% of these people are not going to get anything more than at worst a mild infection. Most will be asymptomatic. That is becoming very clear. Almost nobody under the age of 50 or so is going to die unless they have some pre-existing condition. My contention is all these people should go back to work, should be permitted to go back to work so that we can keep the wheels of the economy moving forward. This to me would be the right balance going forward. And if instead of this we are simply going to extend the lockdown any further, as has been for the last 2.5 weeks, that I am not convinced about at all. I can't say I'm against it because I have no locus standi to be against it, but I'm certainly not convinced about it.
This was Rajiv Bajaj, a concerned person for India, and he says if there are examples, case studies throughout the world that homeopathy is the way to increase the immunity, then why not give it a try? With Cameron Gopalharani, this is Pankaj Khelkar in Pune.